Minted.
Hello everyone, and welcome to my Luigi's Mansion walkthrough. This is a game that I have wanted to do for a very, very long time, and now with my new gaming setup, well, I should say my new recording setup, I'm able to do that now. So let's start a new game, and here we go. We start out in a very lush green forest. The birds are chirping. It's a sunny day outside, not a cloud in the sky. And Luigi won a mansion, and he's going to find where that mansion is using that map, and holy cow! That doesn't look anything like the picture there. Well, I suppose we should go check it out anyway. Those are those crows that talk to you in Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door, or they talk to themselves when you're in your shadow form. If you recall. Okay, maybe they're not the same crows, but just thought I would make a little reference there. Time to enter the mansion! Alright, we're here. The first floor. This is the foyer, if I'm not mistaken. Yep. And, we're pretty much defenseless at this point, but don't worry, we don't have to really fight anything. I'll go over the controls when I get the item that I need to, like, progress further into this mansion, but basically control stick move, B button turns your flashlight on and off if you hold it, the C button controls your flashlight wherever you want it to go, as well as your direction. You can change your control style to like sidestep here, and you'll control like this, and then you can use the C stick to change your facing direction like that, but that's awkward like crazy, so I just stick with the standard one, which is just the control stick to move. You'll notice that there's a door here with thorns on it. If you press the A button next to it, you'll take damage. You can't go through there just yet. So we just gotta go up here. You have to try this door, just saying, but I'm gonna show you what it looks like when you try doors. Yeah, when a door is locked, you can't open it like that. And you can't even check your map just yet. You'll get a map later on, but once you check this door, something will happen. And you'll notice Luigi's just a little bit scared. He's got a very, very cold, steamy breath there. That's sort of a reference to ectoplasmic beings being in an area. They say they cool the air around you. Or at least that's what those shows and books and stuff like that about ectoplasmic and ghostly things, whatever you want to call them, due to the air around you. And you'll notice that it drops a key. And then goes into that room. And you'll notice that that key is pretty small in size, but it seems to grow in size once that cutscene ends. Well, anyway, collect the key and don't question the game logic. Woo! Okay, now that opens the door where that ghost went into, so that's our next destination. And here we go! Suspenseful. Yeah, I just want to show a couple of those cutscenes. You can skip those. Ah! Hello there. Oh! He's got a vacuum cleaner! It's Ghostbusters! This has gotta be a reference to Ghostbusters, I swear. Anyway, that's Professor E. Gadd. Yes, his middle initial is E, his last name is Gadd. And, he just took a little bit of damage there from battling that ghost. That ghost is known as a Jabber. And, nice to meet you too. But it looks like you got the tool to stop these ghosts. I don't know why this house is really haunted, but it's a pretty dang spooky place, I have to say. Oh, I won this mansion in some contest I didn't really seem to enter or something, I don't know. Oh my god. One! Alright, so now we're gonna go back to his laboratory, which is here. And, yeah, my name's Luigi. We were? I mean, they're meant to cross? How do you know that? Yeah, this is ghost studying. You do ghost research? Oh boy, this doesn't seem to... Did you just scratch your butt? Yeah, in case you didn't realize, Luigi is very, very scared of ghosts. So, it's more of a comedic thing more than anything. He's even scared of his laboratory, as you can see here. He's very, very cowardly, but Luigi is awesome. I like Luigi. But anyway, I'm rambling on here. It's time to start the little tutorial thing of the, how to control that vacuum. Yeah, we're gonna get that vacuum. It's called the Polder Gusts 3000, if I'm not mistaken. And, yeah, evidently my brother, Mario, is now trapped in the mansion. Yeah, can you believe that? We're rescuing Mario for once! Yeah, it's unbelievable! This is the first time... Well, actually, it's not. We had to rescue Mario, and Mario is missing. But I don't count that game as part of the Mario series. Look it up if you want to know about it. I don't recommend you do, because it'll probably scar you for life. Anyway, yeah, this vacuum cleaner, it's designed to catch ghosts. It's the Poltergust 3000. As I said... And, yeah, so, basically, the idea to catch ghosts is to stun them with your flashlight, and then suck them in with the vacuum. You have to expose their hearts for them to be vulnerable to it, and, yeah, you'll get the idea once I start it. You can control your vacuum just like you did with the, flashlight with the C-stick to aim it at different angles and stuff like that. But anyway... We shall get into stuff like that as we go through this walkthrough. So, I recommend that what you do is turn off your flashlight, wait till a ghost gets close, stun it, and then suck it in with your vacuum. A tip to suck in a ghost faster is to continuously tap the control stick in the opposite direction. And he says to tilt it in the opposite direction. What you want to do is keep tapping it like you're doing smash attacks in Super Smash Brothers. And you'll be able to suck in ghosts faster than what you would normally do if you were to just hold that direction. And that's key to getting a good score in this game. You see, what I'm going to be aiming on doing is getting the top score in this game, and is getting the A rank of this game, which you have to get $100 million to do. That seems pretty daunting. Especially since there's $142,390,000 to find in this mansion, and you can lose money by getting bumped by things. So, you gotta be pretty careful not to take too many hits here, especially if you miss some things, and you're bound to miss a lot of things. It's pretty much impossible to 100% this game, because of the way this game is designed. I want to stun a load of ghosts, and let me stun. There we go. Woo! Normally, if you stun and suck in two ghosts at the same time, you'll get a heart from it, if I'm not mistaken. But this is just training, so it doesn't really count. But I did get my health recovered somehow. I don't know how. But those ghosts, as you can see, they don't really harm you. They just kind of scare you. They're there for the tutorial. But, yeah, let's go to the gallery. I'll describe this, and when we get here, you'll notice that there's a portrait here. Well, this portrait is... It changes depending on how much money you get at the end of the game. The rest of these portraits are known as portrait ghosts, which are special ghosts. I'll be getting every single one of them. And I'll also be getting all the boos in this game, which I'll be getting later. There's 23 portrait ghosts, if I'm not mistaken, to get. Yeah, as you can see, all these portraits are blank. You can take a look around here. This is the final portrait ghost room here. It's very sparkly and goldish, and you'll notice that when you walk over bricks in there, Luigi actually walks, you know, he walks as if there's like a texture on the floor. It's a little bit of polish, I have to say, that's towards this game, which is pretty nice, I have to say. So now you talk to Gadd here, and he'll say his 21 paintings. But, yeah, they're only statues, unfortunately. But, what you should do now is check things with the Game Boy Horror, he'll say. So, what you want to do is press the X button and examine the angel statues. You'll go into first-person mode, which is something that you can use to explore the area. You can look in any direction, so these aren't just, like, pre-rendered rooms. They're full 3D rooms, basically, and you want to just examine the angel statue. And that's all you have to do, and now you can leave here. And, yes, I am. Well, you can ask him where you are and stuff like that, but you really... Well, actually, if I ask this, he'll actually give you a little explanation of the machine that he made and stuff like that. And then he'll tell you a story. Lossus was number 22, evidently. But there's 23 ghosts that you can get, but for some reason he only says there's 21. So, I don't know, maybe I guess you get more than what's in his gallery? I don't know. But there's definitely 23 portrait ghosts you can get. So, yeah, he's basically saying that everyone else will call him crazy and wouldn't believe him. And, to be honest, if he told the story to me, I wouldn't believe him either. Anyway, let's go back to the lab. I already explained the Game Boy Horror to you. It'll also give you a map. I'll show you that when I get to the mansion. And here we go, second visit. Alrighty. Now, as I said, you can check things with the Game Boy Horror. Now, you'll notice that there's a crying toad there. I'm not going to do anything just for a minute. I want to turn on my vacuum and suck the sheet off this mirror here. These mirrors, basically whenever you see one, if you examine it with your Game Boy Horror, you'll be warped to this area, to this foyer. That is a great way to take a shortcut if you ever need to. Obviously, it's not going to do anything because, you know, I'm already in the foyer. But anyway, talk to this toad here, and he'll be like, "Oh, where did Mario go? Oh no, Luigi, you're second best, but I guess I can deal with you. I guess you're okay. You're kind of there, and yeah." That's basically what he's saying. He was hoping for Mario, but he got Luigi instead. But don't worry, Luigi here will rescue everyone. I always take a lot of time in this first part to explain everything and joke around, but... believe me, things will pick up a little bit later. And, goodbye. I don't really need you. Okay, I'll help you out. Fine. And what that will do is it'll clear the room. You'll notice the room just got light. Whenever a room gets light, it means it's cleared. When it's dark, it's not cleared and you can find ghosts in it. There's actually... Oh, toads also act as a save point, I should add. There's also something that I should add, is that when you're in a cleared room, you can find boos once you open them from their areas. Well, actually I'll explain that later. So forget what I said there. You can use your vacuum to put out flames and shake things up and see if there's anything in things. This is something that you definitely want to do. Is shake things around to see if you can find things. If you stand... Wait, no, it's not here just yet. If you shake up this chandelier up here, this is one of the things you can do with your vacuum. It'll release a load of cash and money. The coins there are worth $5,000. The paper money there is worth $20,000. So it's definitely worth your time to loot this place of as much money as you possibly can. And if you stand too far in the middle here, the chandelier is going to go crazy and try and kill you!